shit. My father, my lawyer, true story. Boy, mom, 7 years ago, my guitar, my lawyer, my lawyer, my lawyer. That's to my father.
Sunny day, a young Filipino man was relaxing in his apartment in San Jose. An incredible artist, he took part in spiritual work, the elevation of his mind in the healing of an earth. Not out to find another, he was out to find himself first, cause hereditary dysfunction was my bloodline family curse. Out to break it cause mistakes had made his whole reason for living, given the fact that he's got his whole life ahead of him. But by his energy and mentally you can tell he's an old soul that received a new vehicle. On October 8th, 1956 in San Francisco, one of the children himself, his pops took a shortcut and a long run. But tell you what, the path that he chose was definitely a wrong one. I know the universal importance of his son, who contained the seeds to breed of many great ones. And although mother had many others, none like this young bright shining light, who sat in apartment hallways while his mother tended to no game, low life. For money, support his family, she sacrificed almost anything for her kids, and she did. And most of the relatives wasn't liking the way she lived, but she could give a fuck, cause she was free from the ghettos of the Philippines and wanted to live it up. A strong-headed, open-minded, beautiful peanut queen, Miss Blair with spark energy between men with the way your eyes gleam. Seems to women was a goddess. Beautiful long black hair, eyes of the stars and earth tone brown skin. Many men neglected the fact soon as their eyes struck with the striking young Philippine eye. One night a man approached her while drinking at a bar. He was a charmer, promised to keep mama securely safe and never let anything harm her. Mama thought she found a prince charming lad. Few months went by and cherishing times was had. Everything seemed so perfect, little ones was taken care of by all the different dads. It was comrades with the ex-women passing on the seeds to a little nomad. A little nomad. She was about to go out, thinking nothing of the night. Hit the bar, sip some drinks and get herself some do-right. When this bitch approached with a look of revenge and sparked up a fight. You see my Lola ain't no sucker, she was sticking with left and right. When this bitch pulled out the knife and sliced off the roots of my family tree, taking my Lola, our history, and most of all what's important to me. Let's celebrate your chance in POW camps when the elephants dance.